Hello students, today we will discuss about chapter 14 of our English grammar, that is related to has, have and had. So let's start. Look at here, has and have used for present action and had for past action. These three are used for possessive, means belonging to me, belonging to other. Means हम अगर बोले कि ये चीज मेरे पास है या ये चीज उसके पास है, that is connected to other person or people. Now we can say that I have a phone, I have a toy, she had a toy, like this. Look at here. I am writing an example. I have a toy. It means मेरे पास एक खिलौना है. And have is uses for belongingness. And this is belong to me. Okay students? So let's start the rule of has have. Look at here. Has is used for singular. Singular means a one person, a one thing. Look at here. When the subject is he, she, it. And in singular noun, we will use has with it. And have used for plural. Subject. If a subject is I, they, we, you, and related to plural noun, we will use have. I am writing an example. Look at here. Ram has an apple. Here, Ram is a singular. So, I use has here. And in another, boys have a car. Here, boys is as a plural noun and I use have with it. Okay? But, had uses the past action and it is used with all these subjects. There is no differentiate in it. Had is used with all subject, means he, she, it, singular noun, I, we, they, you, and plural noun. All with all subject and all the singular and plural subject we will use had, okay, for the belongingness. Now let's see exercise of this chapter. Look at here, your first exercise. This is question.
Plural subject, so we will use
we will do? We will choose subject. Here is she is a subject. She is a singular. And we will use for singular subject has. She has many brothers. Now third, we plan a wedding to go to on Sunday. Here, firstly we see subject. Here is we as a subject. We is a plural, so we will use have with it. Okay, we have a wedding to go on Sunday. Now, fourth one is they blend a white car. Here, subject is they and indicating plural. So, we will use have with it. Now, fifth, he blend a younger brother. Here, he is a subject and he is for singular person, male person. So, we will use has with it. And so on, you will use, you can easily choose has and have for each subject. Now, look at another exercise related to had. So, how can we choose had? Had is indicating for past tense. So, in a sentence, if any word that tell us about a past action, so we will choose had. We will write had. Now, here in it, we use three of these. We will choose three from three of these. Now, look at here. Exercise number A, choose the correct word. In it, we will choose from three of these. Now, first is here, Khushi. Khushi blank a cold last week. Okay? In it, here, last week's means an action that happened before now. Yani past tense. So what we will fill it? We will fill had here. Khushi had a cold last week. Now second, we blend 10 toes. There is no action that happened in the past. So we will choose from has and have. So which one is correct? Have, because we is as a plural. So, we choose have. We have 10 toes. Now, third, the students plan to submit their homework today. So here today is indicating a present tense and the action that happens now. So we will choose from has and have, and here we will see subject firstly. So here is a plural subject, means students, bahut sare bacche. So we will write have here. Okay, now fourth is we blank a power cut last night. Again, this sentence tells us action of the past and indicating past tense. So, we will choose only had, because for had we will not see any subject. All the subject, with all the subject we choose had. So, we will write here had. We had a power cut last night. Now, fifth word. Karan blank a smile on his face. In it, there is no difference. exercise number B that is related to all these, but we will choose according to the sentence. Now, here I am writing question. Choose the correct word. So, in your book, in exercise B, these three actions are written, but we will only choose one for each sentence. So, one, you blend a sweet voice. Here, has, have, I'm writing according to your book. We, has, have, and had. Okay, in bracket, a sweet voice. You should be a singer where you grow up. So, in this sentence, there is no action related to past. So, what we will choose? We will leave had and only focus on has and have. And here we see you as a subject. So, you is a plural subject. So, which one is correct? Have. So, we will choose have. You have a sweet voice. You should be a singer when you grow up. Now, second, students, according to this, you will choose. I blend rice and fish curry for lunch yesterday. In this, yesterday is indicating a past action and telling us a past tense. So, what we will write here? We will write had. I had rice and fish curry for lunch yesterday. Okay, student? So, firstly, we should see in a sentence any past action. If there is no past action, we will choose from has and have for the present tense. But for has, we will choose singular. We will write has with singular subject and have for plural subject. Now, third one is they blend a football match tomorrow. So, in it, there is no past action. So, what we will do? We will write only present action that has and have, and they is related to plural subject. So, what we will write? We will write have here. They have a football match tomorrow. Mark black, green eyes. So, here is no any past action. Here is mark a name of one person. So, what we will write? We will write has. Here for belongingness, Mark has a green eyes. Now, fifth is Yukti. Yukti Black won a gold medal for athletics. So, in it, Yukti is a singular subject and name of a girl. So, what we will write? Has. Now, sixth one is last month. Beta, there is not necessary. A past action should be, will be in last of sentence. It can be at the first of the sentence and at the starting of the sentence. Last month, we blank आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड ऑल दिस एंड रिवाइज एंड डू दिस चैप्टर विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.